Hello everyone, welcome to another week of the Track Guide. Today we are at the circuit of Zandvoort in Netherlands, and today No More Pro Player will be showing you what lines to take and how to drive on this circuit, which has been newly added in the F1 calendar. For fuel, I will be taking 38 laps of fuel, considering that the race is 36 laps. I generally tend to take 2 extra laps of fuel. Tires, I will be going out on a soft compound because that is the strategy that many people prefer, soft to hards on this track. So I will be demonstrating all my demonstrating to you guys on the soft tires itself. So I will be demonstrating in 2 laps. The first lap will be just to show the lines, a very slow lap, and the second one will be quite fast lap, showing you the gears and the speed you can take each corner in. Coming to the pit exit itself, it's a very tricky pit exit, so it's just one car wide. Tend to not exceed the white line, otherwise you might receive some penalty if you exceed the white line. Coming to this corner, you tend to just go on the inside and let your car drift wide. This corner is taken differently by many people, but I tend to go wide on the entry and then straighten my car as soon as possible and then exit it out to get on the throttle that early for this long straight. This is a pretty long straight where you there are few chances of overtake, but again it's very narrow. Coming to this corner, you brake a little, get back on the throttle immediately and let your car drift wide to the outside curb. Do not get on the curb, otherwise you will be pulled into the gravel. The next corner, you will aim for the kink. You can touch it or you may avoid it and again let your car drift wide. As you brake for the next corner, you aim to again touch the curb on the inside and again let your car drift wide. Again, it is about maximizing the track. For the next corner as well, again entry wide, going on the inside and again drifting out, making sure not to touch either the inside or the outside curb, because both of them will unsettle your car no matter what. Next corner of chicane is pretty tricky. I tend to bound the first curb and then again stay as close to the inside as possible and again drift wide without going on the curb on the outside, because again it will unsettle your car. Last corner is pretty easy. You tend to not touch the inside one and let your car drift wide, and this is the banking where you can easily just go full throttle on the car. Now we go on a proper hot lap, proper lap with this car. So coming on the first corner, late braking and going as inside as possible. From third you short shift to fourth and then again climb on the gears. One downshift, a bit of brake, again short shift to at least not let your car spin out, and again short shift to fourth on the exit of the banking curve to keep your rear a bit stable. And on this straight you climb through the gears. For the next corner, downshift one, a little bit braking and immediately back on power. Again for this next kink, again one downshift, a bit brake, back on power. For this corner, you downshift 2, let the car drift and then again get back slowly on power. Again one downshift, one brake, slowly on the throttle, making sure you do not get that extra wheel spin and lose your car. For the next chicane, you downshift to 4th and downshift once again after you cross the chicane to turn your car in and go on the throttle slightly. And then for this corner, you downshift again once and brake a bit and go back on power. So most of the corners on this track have one downshift and a bit of brake and back on power kind of attitude, so you can follow that a lot on most of the corners on this track. Now moving on, we have a hot lap by me, so let's go over to the hot lap. So coming to the setup, I am using a setup that is generally used by most of the esports driver, but I have done some minor tweaks to it. You can definitely use this or do your own tweaks. For the wings, I'm using a 4-7 wing. Again, some people do prefer a 3-8 or a 4-8 wing setup for more rear stability. For diff, I am again going with a very high on diff because I really like the on diff to turn my car in a corner. So my on diff is 75% while my off diff is 50%. But definitely, if you are losing your car a lot on the corner, then definitely go for a lower diff. Suspension is right, left, left, but not full to the right, because again, you want your camber to be less to have that stability in the car. For geometry, it's 133.835. Again, ride height. You can reduce the ride height a bit, but again, you can lose your car if you are going in the fast part of the second sector. So that's why, suspension is 1.3. Otherwise, you might lose your car there. Brakes are 100% brake pressure and 50% brake bias. Again, personal preference. I generally prefer the highest brake pressure possible, and tire pressures, as usual, the lowest, as it is the funda in F1 2020 game. So thank you guys for watching this tutorial/track guide. Hope it will help you improve your race pace, and we'll see you soon in the next week video.